It was the early 1980s, and my husband was a famous editor in Dallas, Texas. We moved to a Midwest town called Fort Wayne, Indiana, where we bought a brick house. In a beautiful neighborhood. We had a son and an infant daughter. The Herald Dispatch in Fort Wayne was where my husband was the editor. He decided to write an article that had to do something that he may have been warned about, but he was brave. He had no idea the ramifications of the article and if it had anything to do with the mob. Our neighborhood had beautiful lights and a grassy knoll. Our son had many friends. They would play till the lights came on, just like any other night. Except the last night, it must have been a weekend, and I stayed downstairs. There was some noise in the kitchen, and I walked back, and I was met by a man. And all I remember was his eyes. And his eyes told me what he was going to do to me. He pushed me back, and I grabbed a radio, and I swung it at him. He took it from me, and he beat me, and he beat me till I fell. He didn't stop, and I remember laying there thinking, he's not gonna stop. After he was finished with me, he walked up the stairs into the master bedroom, where he saw my son laying beside his father because he must have and was scared. He went to the bed and he stabbed my son and my husband to death. Then he walked to my infant daughter's room and picked her up out of her crib and walked her around and showed her our dead bodies. She was crying. Then he found a pair of scissors. And he kept stabbing her in places that you could not imagine. He left the scissors inside my daughter and he placed her back inside the crib. The next day, the boys from the neighborhood in the windows and knock on the door. There's no answer. They wanted to play with my son. It must have been a weekend because nobody missed my husband at the Herald Dispatch. Later, our bodies were found. A man who was suspected of killing us was arrested and held. And they found him dead in his cell by hanging with a note that said, "I didn't kill no one." Our killers were never found. And no one one even tried to find out who it was. Our house still sits, and the boys who looked in the windows, they still remember. To this day. No one ever cared.